We're out here today to test the Asics Court FF 3. Let's get started.
I wanted to start off this playtest as the most narrow-footed playtester, and when I slipped these shoes on my feet, I was really happy with the fit. There wasn't any extra room from the front all the way to the heel. I thought that these shoes fit my feet perfectly. Now I slipped them on, walked around in them for about 1 to 2 hours, and then headed down to court. Didn't really need a break-in period with these. I thought that the cushioning was excellent. I think Asics really upped it from the previous version. Lots of nice cushioning underfoot as well as around the ankle. I also thought the stability was excellent as well, especially that ankle stability, which I need. I didn't experience any soreness or tenderness after or during a hit. Another thing was the durability, both on the outsole and the toe durability was excellent. At the end of the playtest, I saw very minimal to no wear. Another thing I wanted to mention was the traction. I'm not much of a slider, but what I do like is after I hit a ball to have a little bit of give in my shoes, and this shoe did it perfectly. I was able to seamlessly transition from one shot to another. One thing I did want to mention was about halfway through the playtest, I noticed that the upper did start to open up a little bit, and I was able to use that last eyelet as well as tighten up the laces kind of closer to the front to kind of cinch my foot in a little bit tighter as I was experiencing some movement back and forth. Overall, this is a really great play test, and I'm having a hard time deciding between this Court FF 3 and the Asics Gel Res 9, as I really like the fit of this shoe, but the high performing characteristics of the Gel Res 9.
The previous version of these shoes were some of my favorites, so this playtest was going to be a challenging one to meet those expectations. And the slight changes that Asics has made, the upper felt definitely more flexible, but it also felt a little bit more supportive and sometimes restrictive. But what I do love about these shoes is they take color really well, and I often wear the men's colors because I think they're really cool and a little brighter sometimes. So the men's shoe fit me perfectly, had no issues with that whatsoever. As far as durability, I am seeing some decent wear after a couple weeks of playtesting these, but what I love about this shoe as well is the support and the stability. I am not a hard court slider, I barely can slide on clay courts, but I felt so confident changing direction in these shoes, and I felt like I could start on a dime. So definitely a positive for me from this playtest.
And now I actually have the widest feet on the playtest team. And so for me, I definitely noticed that snugness right away. These shoes are actually a little bit difficult for me to get on. The opening is really not super wide at the ankle, which is actually very supportive, and I always felt secure. However, it made the shoes getting the shoes on quite difficult. I really wish there were a tab or something to hold and to pull on for the heel. And so I'm worried that as I put my foot in there, I am actually going to damage the heel of these shoes over time. Once I got my feet in there, I did really notice that snug and supportive, and it was a little too narrow for my wide feet. However, it was never painful. I always did feel supported, and there was no issue with toe jamming or anything like that, just a very snug fit. When I was moving on court, I also really appreciated the traction levels. It's definitely not quite as sticky and definitely quieter than the FF2, so I could slide out of my shots. I am not a hard court slider either, but I think if you are, you would be able to do so quite nicely in these shoes. As far as durability, I'm getting some wear, not a lot, but I am noticing some wear after about a dozen hours or so on the hard court. Overall, I do find these to be a nice cushioned shoe and a good blend of features, as they don't feel heavy. They do seem to offer some good durability, excellent support. However, they're just not a great fit for my wide feet. Those were our thoughts on the Asics Court FF3. Next, we're gonna check in with Jofi in Georgia. How'd these shoes work for you?
Thanks, Tiff. I was actually a huge fan of the previous generation of the Court FF, so I was super excited to see how this new update compares. With the Court FF2, a couple of the standout features were stability and a speedy feel, and I felt like those characteristics remained the same with this one. When I first put the shoes on, I felt like the new update comes in a bit more narrow, unfortunately. So because of that, I would actually pick a men's size, because they do tend to come in a bit wider, so that would be a good fix, in my opinion. Otherwise, when you first look at the shoes, they do seem a bit bulky and heavy, and they do weigh in at the heavier side. But actually, when you put them on and play on court, you really don't feel that weight. So I did feel very speedy on court, even with the bulkier look. I always felt extremely supported in my steps, so changing directions, it was very easy, and I wasn't worried about rolling my ankles at all. So that's really a standout feature of the shoe. One more thing that I really liked about this update is that I really like sliding on the court sometimes. You know, I grew up playing on the clay court, so I appreciate the shoe that kind of lets me slide out of certain shots a little bit and change directions that way. And this Court FF3 allowed me to do just that. Durability doesn't seem to be an issue at all with this update. I think they're really durable, so no problems there at all. Unfortunately, I do have a knock about this shoe, which is it feels like the updated material on the upper folds in a kind of weird way, which was just something I noticed, but honestly, it won't affect performance at all. So all in all, if you're looking for a very stable yet speedy option that will support you on the court, definitely give this one a go. Thanks for watching. For more information on this shoe and many others, please go check out Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Hero for tennis only.